for a while.
You know, probably you're just going to go to one of them.
Well, you know, I'm the only attorney in the room. I'm the only member of the bar, which was code for I can be heard. A lot of people
are wrong. But you're not going to know that if you don't go.
In law, so, only the person that can be heard is an agent.
And
you're a living being, and the living cannot communicate.
Is,
it's weird. That's that sovereign citizen side.
Develop a social networks.
But I know
that's what
I living cannot communicate.
We can educate the bear catchers on the common core and vice versa.
But if I don't put this back here,
hey, Carol,
you're good.
They're going to think I'm going to forget.
Okay. All righty. We'll wait for you.
Everybody I talked to yesterday voted early.
We're inside South Asia.
Good.
That's good. Well, but Sam's a video editor, so I can't.
I don't need
that. What I don't like is when the video is done too late. I can tell Vimeo to go black. I can tell it to bring up this whole other list of videos.
Yeah.
On YouTube, you can't control that.
That's okay. I'm preferring not being there. All right, thank you. You ready? All right. For the last 5 years, this body where we are held at the Capitol has not been run on the principles of a representative democracy that the people of Georgia would expect. Your representatives cannot vote to determine what bills are going to be heard in the committee. The Rules Committee members cannot vote to select bills on a list that can be moved to the floor for a vote. They also cannot vote on how to determine and structure a bill for debate on the floor and how to limit that debate or how to may open it up. They cannot vote on that. They can, however, tamper with bills, and the leadership can tamper with bills that without the permission of the author or on a floor vote. Decisions are made on bills and amendments without recorded votes. And legislators are not even allowed 24 hours in some cases to look at a bill before they're forced to vote. So what we've had here for the last few years is not the principles of representative democracy. It is more of a dictatorship that is controlled by a single individual, which is the Speaker of the House. As a result of that dictatorship, the money from the lobbyists and PACs flow into the very top of the House, and that specifically would be the Speaker's campaign contributions, if you've noticed, is now about $1 million. So in addition to this, and to facilitate that dictatorship, chairmen and people at House leaderships are expected, and we believe they are required, to fund other House races. I want to give you an example of this, a visual that will really hit home for you. This is an example from last year, 2012, in a primary. On this side, we have legislators have put in $27,000 to this particular candidate, led by $5,000 of the speaker's money to start things off. That gave their candidate a 5-to-1 spending advantage over his opponent, who happened to be a minister. This candidate raised 93% of his money from legislators, lobbyists, and corporations, while the minister raised 96% of his money from individuals. The total amount of money raised by this candidate from individuals was approximately 6% of his total campaign funds. The rest of the money came from corporations, lobbyists, PACs, and legislators to the tune of over $50,000, which allowed him to essentially win the election, and this seat was purchased essentially by the legislators in this House that we stand in right now. That subverts the will of the people of all of these districts. This is just one simple example. It's happening over and over again, and I'm sure the people behind me know many more examples of that occurring. occurring. Another example that some of you might be familiar with occurred on the 21st of February. We had a tremendous controversy over a bill that was introduced by a representative. It just so happens that controversy, which was created primarily, we believe, by the speaker and the leadership, those same individuals, many of them, had already funded this representative's opponent to the tune of $17,000. And there are the campaign contributions for you. This particular person who was funded by the legislature and PACs and corporations had a total of about $30,000 total, but only $800 came from individuals within the district. So again, there was another attempt to purchase this seat, and this in which it happened to be District 22, with a representative out there who had entered a bill which they claimed to be abusive or and actually would be dangerous for children. Now, I want to mention before I started this, this representative that happens to be the target of this attack that we're discussing, this representative does not take any money from PACs, lobbyists, corporations, or legislators. Zero money. But if you remember back on February 21st, the speaker and the leaders claimed that this bill, which repealed watering laws, would in fact jeopardize children. So I wanted to bring the laws for you today so that you can see exactly what they are. First of all, the watering laws say that they apply only at unusual times.
You got to put the
mic.
I'm sorry about that.
Higher,
yeah, because. Okay, is that okay? Better. Sorry. So the lottery laws, let's talk about this. The lottery laws apply only at unusual times when children would not be present. So to remove the laws is not going to endanger children because they would not be present when you would allegedly be accused of lottering. Let me read to you the law. A person commits the offense of lottering or prowling when he is in a place, at a time, or any manner not unusual for law-abiding citizens. In addition, children are protected with the Child Protection Act, OCJA 21-2-1180. And I'll read from you that. It shall be unlawful for any person to remain upon premises or within a school safety zone. Now, if those of you who have children, like I do, and I have an 11-year-old daughter, know that as a parent, you cannot even remain on school grounds. So the premise that you heard from the speaker and the legislators that children were going to be endangered by repeal of the lottery laws is just flat out not true. Furthermore, the children are protected by the state sex offender registry laws 42.115, which says no individual shall reside within 1,000 feet of any type of child care facility, church, school. No individual shall be employed or volunteer at any business or entity that's located within that individual being someone who could possibly be a predator. Furthermore, children are further protected by the law of OCG 42.114, which requires any predator to wear an electronic monitoring device. So these are the child protection laws that are in place today that the legislatures who stood up on the well on February 21st should have known for a while were in force. So I raise all these points so you understand that the premise of the charge against this representative was totally bogus. And it was done because of the campaign contributions and attempt to destroy the re-election chances of that particular representative. So to sum up here, we have basically, as I've explained, the House has been run as a dictatorship. We've gone over the details of that, and we need to correct that. We have shown legislators tampering with elections against the will of the people and controlling the outcome of these elections with massive amounts of funds that are not coming from the voters of this district. And thirdly, we've shown what I believe to be a complete lack of that of advocacy, which is a false information generated on the floor of the House and a staged media event attempting to destroy a candidate's re-election chances, just because that candidate doesn't take PAC money, corporation money, lobbyist money, and legislator money, and he's not playing the game that, properly. That's pretty disturbing. For these reasons, many of the people that you see behind me have sent a letter to the governor. We're going to lay this at his feet and ask him to do something. We believe that there's ethics charges and ethics possible violations in all this that has occurred. And I want to show you a report that many of you are familiar with. It says Georgia ranks 50th, dead last, in, as the most politically corrupt state in America. We specifically received F's in political financing, legislative accountability, and ethics enforcement agencies. Our ethics enforcement agency got a zero score from this Center of Public Integrity. Now, if many of you also know that our Ethics Commission was recently found unethical themselves in a recent $700,000 judgment that they had to pay for the first of three wrongful termination suits. So we have no recourse to get this corrected with the Ethics Commission, and we feel that the best thing to do is to deliver a letter to the governor and ask the governor, as his power as the chief executive officer of the state and as the top position in his political party, which has control of the legislature, both House and Senate, we feel that the burden should now fall to him, and we will deliver this information to him now today and hope that we will be able to get a better government for the people of Georgia and one that actually represents their will and not the will of lobbyists, PACs, corporations, and other legislators who are not even in their district. Thank you very much.
My point was, if he's doing it for the right reason, folks, and not getting any money at all.
I'm going to walk this into the governor's office and we can continue the conversation.
I'm going to walk this into the governor's office and the speaker.
Now?
Yes, yeah, yeah. Just come on. We can keep your conversation going. We're just going to walk. If y'all are uncomfortable, you know, just need a few of us.
Come on. Yeah, we know.
Just need a few of us.
Barbara, you've never been.
We just want to leave a letter for the governor to expressing some concern from some of the leaders that we have in regards to the operations in the House and representative democracy that really is not being fulfilled right now in this spot, as well as some election manipulations that are going on. And we wanted to bring that to the attention of the governor because we felt he was in the best position to be able to do something about it. We're not getting any action anywhere else.
Thank you.
Thank you. Oh, yeah. Can I get a receipt on that? Can you give me a receipt on that?
A timestamp or something on there? Do you mind that the office received it? That's all. Could you make a copy of the timestamp?
We got the cameras.
Could you run a copy of it and timestamp one and give us the copy back? You can keep the original. Mine?
Thank you.
Thanks, appreciate it. Yeah, I will leave your card.
Nathan's already probably got one.
You were real nice when I came in here one day and you said, well, if you want to write him a note. And I wrote him a note and put it in the box. You said he reads all those, so.
They're out in the hall.
Sometimes you don't.
And you'll let us know?
I need to draw on the matter,
too. You want your original?
Thank you.
He's pretty awesome.
Thank you very much. Welcome.
Thank you.
Thank you very much. We appreciate it. Thank you.
We just got on. It's a show to come.
Yeah, she was supposed to let us know, so.
Thank you.
Go ahead.
So did you meet, you know what happened to the mayor, right?
No.
Some woman came in while this video.
Of course. You do anything less, then you get trampled over.
Yeah.
You're coming down with wrong work.
So what brought you to come in, though? That case? Come on, Gail.
Hello. We just needed to leave a copy of a letter.
It's a very important letter.
Thanks, sir.
That's him. I need to CC the speaker most.
Hi.
Hi.
Hey, can I help y'all?
Yes. Yes, I was wondering if we could just leave a copy of this letter and for Speaker Ralston, and maybe probably need a copy. Would you mind? Can you
make you a copy?
Could we copy and stamp it? Could
maybe
you stamp some
copies? Time stamps. We know it's been received.
Okay. Hold on a minute.
Sure.
This young man is very impressive. He's got some great. I know.
Yes, he's gone places.
He is. I may be campaigning for you.
Yeah, that's why. Luckily, after May 20th, once I know who my opponent is, they're gonna wreak hell and brimstone when it comes that time.
So I didn't know you were running.
Yes, for county commission, District 6.
Oh, you are.
What South district?
That's South Fork.
Can we vote for you in North Fork?
No. And there'll be other races that are individuals countywide to be able to support
I don't really have a date stamp. I just don't use that. Can I just sign it right somewhere down here?
You can sign it wherever you want.
Where do you want me to just receive?
On the front, just say if you could just
receive
by.
Okay, received by.
Thank you kindly.
Appreciate it.
You're welcome. And today is 4/29 or 8.
29.
Okay. I hadn't written the date yet today. There you go.
Thank you so much. Okay.
Appreciate it.
Thank you.
Have a great day.
Bye-bye.
Thanks.
Ladies
first.
Okay, thanks. This lady over here, Beauty, is the woman that... Girl that's filming, this is Gabby that went to our
Thank mayor's. You for beauty, but tell me what you
is. I think we're done. We're going to go to the towers to lunch.
Okay.
Yeah, meet a couple of people over there.
All right.
Yeah, I have other obligations.
Thank you so much.
No, no.
For coming
up? No, no. Thank you.
Yes,
Garland. Thank you, sir.
Thank you. Okay. Putting this together. Thanks. Someone called me or something, making me aware.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, I was there.
Garland's amazing.
I think February.
And he saved you 75 cents.
Once you pass the sunset session, you get the federal cap for the
plan. Then he saved a lot more than 75.
Well, then Riley said, she heard all the things. She's one of my filmmakers, not her.
So are you going to be coming out again? I'd like to make a voice against that whole one.
She was afraid.
Tomorrow afternoon, Pennington is doing an open house.
Okay, I've got to take off.
All right, well, nice meeting you. Be careful.
Everybody.
All right,
I'm going to take off.
Have a good day. Be careful. Okay, well, it was really nitty-gritty. At that point, Mike said, it was just not so much. I turned that guy into a part.